Let's take a look at McDonald's, please. Right now, the stock is down a buck at 97. McDonald's facing, some would call it an image problem. What some describe as unhealthy food, drab stores, too many menu items, and the food's not fast enough. We're joined now by brand building consultant Denise Lee Yohn. She wrote the book, What Great Brands Do. Denise, welcome to the program.
Thank you, Stuart.
Now then, do you think that McDonald's needs to rebrand? I mean, they think they've got to rebrand. Give them some advice. What should they
do? Absolutely. I would say that they need to refocus. You know, they've gotten so distracted with chasing so many different customers, so many different products. They need to go back to the core of what they do and really execute well on that.
What's that? Burgers, shakes, and fries?
Yes, and being convenient, being fun, being a place to take your family. All of those things are very important to that brand.
You know, I'm with you. Because when I go to a McDonald's, I've got some of the kids in the car, go to McDonald's, the menu array is huge and it's not fast.
Yes.
I want fast food from a fast food joint.
Sure,
that's what I want.
The menu is too complex for the operators to execute well, and so the customer ends up suffering.
But what about the nature of the food that McDonald's sells? They catch a lot of flack for fries and shakes and fat and all that kind of thing. Do you think they should rebrand towards a more healthy food?
Actually, I think they have quite a good mix right now. I think that they have some more indulgent items, they have some more healthy items. I think the fact is they need to position themselves to appeal to that family customer and not go chasing after Starbucks customers or healthier customers. Really go to their core of who they are.
Fast, direct, limited menu, some healthy stuff out there.
Yes.
And a nice, clean, friendly place for people to hang out in.
Absolutely. And that will bring up all these emotional connections that people have had for McDonald's for so long.
That's important. An emotional connection.
Absolutely.
All kids know the entire McDonald's menu immediately.
Well, and you and I probably have very fond memories from going to McDonald's when we were kids. McDonald's needs to tap into that more, I think.
I was in Hong Kong when they opened the first McDonald's back in the 1970s. That restaurant immediately became the world's top seller of the fish filet sandwich.
Wow.
I don't know whether you
Who knew, right?
Why would you care? Right. I'm going to bring you a check on JCPenney's stock, please. Today it's bringing back its home goods section. It was ditched, that home goods section was ditched by its former CEO, Ron Johnson. So Denise is still here. JCPenney undoing what Ron Johnson did. He tried to make it a bit more upscale. They've walked away from it, gone back to basics. Do you approve of this image redo?
I do. I think it's a very smart move going back to what people, going back to the customers who love JCPenney and what they want from JCPenney. I think they are trying to compete with a Target or Kohl's, and by having a home goods section that provides great products, they'll be bringing those customers back to them.
You are very direct. I'm used to, well, they should do a little bit of this, a little bit of that, and then some of that, and then some of this. You go right at it. That's very good, Denise.
Well, you know, I've studied JCPenney quite a bit, and I think that underneath all of the problems they've had, underneath their failed advertising campaign, failed pricing strategy, etc., was that they lost their focus on their core customer, and they need to go back to that.
Okay. Google is everywhere. Yeah, we mean it. Check this out. Google's added a Grand Canyon River View to its Street View feature on their maps, calling it River View for obvious reasons, of course. The Google stock, have a quick look at it, please. It's down $10, below $1,200 a share. Now, what do you think about this, Denise? The slogan, I always think of Google is everywhere. That's the slogan that I've applied to Google. I think that's a pretty good brand to have, wouldn't you?
Absolutely, and I think that customers really trust Google to do lots of different things to make their lives better.
And they are doing lots of different things.
Yes.
They constantly expand into brand new areas. Even this Riverview thing on Google Maps, that's an extension, I think.
It is, but at the same time, their core mission of Google is to organize the world's information and make it useful and accessible for everyone. This is just one more way that they're doing that, and so it makes a lot of sense for them to do something that's kind of more fun and entertaining.
You create branding, don't you? I mean, a company comes to you and says, I need a brand. Is that right?
Yes. I've worked with some of the world's greatest brands as well as some emerging brands, and so my insights are based on that work.
Tell me a brand that you've polished.
Well,
if you're allowed to.
Yeah, I was going to say, you know, maybe I would turn to Oakley, the sunglass manufacturer that has branched into all sorts of sporting gear and sportswear.
What did you do for them? What did you tell them to do?
You know, well, it was a collaborative process. I always work very much in close in hand with my clients. And, you know, the thing about Oakley is they have so many opportunities in front of them, and they need to decide where are they going to innovate? Where are they really going to emphasize their product innovation and product development? So the process I worked with was helping them provide that focus.
All right. Well, you worked for us, and it was great. Denise, Lee Yohn, thank you very much indeed for joining us.
Thank you, Stuart.
You going to come again?
Absolutely. I hope so.
So it wasn't that bad? Okay. Thanks.
Thanks.